UK Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Okay. So we're going to learn about joins in SQL Server. So joins are primarily used to retrieve the data from one or more tables. So imagine you want to get the data from more than one table, you write join between the two tables and you'll retrieve the data. So we're going to see how to do that. And also we are going to see what are stored procedures and how do we use stored procedures. Okay. Just a second. Okay, so let me open SQL Server. And before that, I got the answers from some of you for the second highest salary. I'm still waiting for the response from others. So let me tell the query for all of you. Okay, so how to get the highest salary? Anyone wants to unmute and tell me how to get the highest salary? For example, let me show you this table. Okay, so select star from employee. I'm going to show it from F5. So I'm going to connect to SQL Server and I want to use the database. See, now by default it's showing invalid object employee because the database which I have selected is master database. So I want to select my database which I want. So I'm going to select .NET Batch 1, which I have created in the previous class, and I'll be using this for our course. So now I'm clicking on Select Star from Employee. Now I want one of you to unmute yourself and tell me how to get the highest salary, first highest salary. Yeah, we go ahead.
Select a top 1 star from Employee order by salary in descending.
So let's verify. So Ravi is telling that select top 1 star from employee, order by salary descending. Let me execute this. Yeah, you're right. Thank you, Ravi. Okay, so this is how we can get the highest salary. Or if you don't want to, or if you don't want to get the name and other details, if you just want to know what is the highest salary, so we can use max. For example, I just want to know what is highest salary. I don't want to know who is getting highest salary. So in that case, I can write here select max of salary from employee. So in this case, I'll be getting what is the maximum salary. So let me execute this. So 32,500 is a maximum salary. Now, if I want to get this person who is getting second highest salary, what I can do is, see here, I'm going to do this. If you're not getting, please ask me, I'll explain that again. So select top 1 star from employee where salary less than select max of salary from employee. So I wrote this query. So select top 1 star from employee where salary less than select max salary from employee. So let me execute this. So before that, let's run this and see who is getting second highest salary. So order by salary descending. So let's execute this and we can notice that the second highest salary is getting by Shankar. So now let me do this. Let me execute this query and say, let's see whether we are getting Shankar or not. So we are getting here Amar. So what is wrong here is I want to do it order by salary descending. So what I need to do here is order by salary descending. So now let's try to execute this. So I'm getting Shankar here. So what I'm trying to do here is I'm just selecting, anyone got this, understood this query? For getting the second highest salary? Okay, so I'm getting not understood from others. So who understood this query for getting second highest salary? So this is the query to get second highest salary. Please ping me in the chat window if you understood this query. I got only one message saying like it is understood. So any others who understood this query? I am taking top one star from employee where salary less than max salary. So who wants to explain this other than Ravi? So I want either Priyanka or Mona to explain this. They said like they understood this. They can unmute yourself and you can explain, one of you. Hello? Mona or Priyanka, can you go ahead? Can you unmute? Yeah, Mona, go ahead, please.
Here it is selecting max other than max salary, means second highest in max salary. Sorry, I can't explain.
Okay, no problem. Okay, so
I can explain.
Yeah, go ahead.
Here the select top one from employee is the, it will give the topmost higher salary. And it should be the second highest will be less than that. So the salary is less than the maximum salary.
Correct. And why do I need this?
Because we have to take a descending order so that highest will be at the top.
Perfect. Yeah. So thank you very much, Mona and Priyanka. Yeah, that's correct. So what I'm trying to do here is, so let's remove this. For example, let's remove this. So if I copy this query, so what is the maximum salary? So if I execute this query, for example, I'm getting 3,500. So which is maximum salary? So let me put this query this way, in the other way. So I'll copy this, I'll paste it here, and then instead of this query, I'm going to put here 32,500 because that's same actually. So let me remove this and put here 32,500. Okay, so now this query is same like writing this query. So select top one star from employee where salary less than 32,500, ordered by salary descending. So now what will happen is, it will not take the maximum salary, it will take the immediate next maximum salary, and since I have mentioned here top one, so that will return me the person who is getting second highest salary. So this is how we write the query to get the second highest salary. So please keep in mind, I attended many interviews. This is a definite question. So I'm leaving it to you for third highest salary or fourth highest salary. So I'm not going to explain this. So you can write another subquery for this, but still there are different ways to do that. So for example, if I was being asked to put the third highest salary with the subqueries, there are a lot of ways to do this, but this way, for example. So again, I write the same thing. So instead of this top one, what I'll do here is select max salary. Okay, and then I'll copy this. And then instead of this one, I will put like this. I'm not going to explain this, otherwise it will be confusing. Let me execute this. Okay, so here, order by is not required. Anyway, it's a maximum salary. Let me execute this. I'm getting Ravi, who is getting 28,000. Is it the correct person who is getting third highest salary? Let me execute this. So let me execute this salary descending, and I'm getting Ravi, who is getting third highest salary, and this query is returning me the third highest salary. So anyway, I'm not going to explain this. For some of it might be confusing, but still it's very easy if you practice it. So this is how we normally get third highest salary, but there are different ways to do this. So please research on this and find the best solution. But for second highest salary, you can tell this. Okay. So now, with this, let's move ahead for joins in SQL Server. Okay, so now let's go to, let me open Excel sheet. Now, how many of you is it clear on getting the second highest salary? So how about Babita, Bhavesh or Bhavik? How about second highest salary? Anyone wants me to explain again? Okay. How about Sarika, Seema, Sanya and is it clear now to get the second highest salary? So feel free to ask me, I'm fine to explain even 5-6 times, that should be fine. So okay, now let's try to understand joins. Okay, so now the reason, so why we, let me show you this. Okay, so I have a table called customer, and I have, okay, I have a document for joins. Let me open that. So is the display is coming later than my voice, or is it in sync? Some of one person is telling like the display is coming before voice. Yeah. I think for those whom it's clear, it's not clear. I think it's problem with your internet speed. So all of I'm getting messages from everyone saying it's clear. Okay. Just a second. Okay, so let me open this joins. Okay, so we're going to learn how to write joins between the tables. So let me tell this. So I'm going to use two tables. One is employee table, and I'm also going to use another table called address table. So for now, I don't have any primary keys. I don't have any identity columns. I don't have anything for this, not null constraints or whatever. So I have two tables, one is employee table, I have another table which is address table. So let's copy this and create this. So to create this table, I want to delete the table which I already have. So let me delete the table. So how to drop the table? So drop table, employee. So let me drop the table. Okay, now let me delete it. Let me go back here and let me copy this. So I'm going to create this table. And let me create this table, and I'm going to create another table which is address. Let me copy this, and here I'm going to create this. Let me execute this. Okay, so I created the table employee and I created the table address. So I have now two tables. One is employee and the address. So let me add some data for the tables. So I'm going to add this data for these two tables. So let me click on new query, and let me add these two insert scripts. So in address, in employee table, I'm going to add 4 rows. In address table, I'm going to add 3 rows. Now let me to select star from employee. Select star from address. So let me execute this. See, table is coming in black color, employee table is coming in black color, but whereas address is coming in blue color, because this looks like this is a keyword for SQL Server. So always avoid using keywords. Address is keyword in SQL Server. So anyway, that should be fine for now. So let me execute this. So I have two tables, one is employee and the address. Now what is my requirement is, I want to print like this. I want to print the details like this. So employee, okay, just for a change, what I'll do is I'll change the city names. I have all the same city here, same state here. So let me change the city and state so that it'll be clear for us. So for this, let's have city Hyderabad, and then let have Andhra Pradesh. Now it is Telangana, and let's have here Bhopal, and if I'm not wrong, this is Madhya Pradesh. Let's have Kolkata. I don't care, I mean spelling might not be correct. Okay, so let me execute this. Okay, so if I see this select star from employee and address, so I have, okay, so now I have three cities and three states. Now what I need from this is, if I want any information from one table, I can easily get it using where condition or using column names. But the problem here is I want to get the data from two tables. So I want data like this. I want employee first name, I want last name, and city, state. I want the details like this. I want first name, last name, and which city he belongs to, which state he belongs to. For example, if I take Ravi, his employee ID 1, so who belongs to Hyderabad and state Telangana. So I want these details. For example, if I take 4, Amarnath is not yet filled the details of address. So we don't see this Amarnath details here. We don't have this in address table. The reason could be he's yet to fill the address details. Okay. So now I want to print these details. For sure I have to write a join. So now if you want to write a join, you will have a common column between the two tables. And what is the common column which I have between the two tables? I have a common column which is employee ID. So based on employee ID, I can tell whether who belongs to which city, who belongs to which state. So now I want to write a join. So let me write a join. So please focus here, very important. So first I need to write what are the columns I need. So select, what are the columns I need? I need F name, I need L name, I need city, I need state. From, which table I need first? Employee. And then I need to write here, I can give some alias name here for this table. I can give EMP. Join. I want to join this with which table? I want to join this with address table. On, what is the condition here? emp.emp.emp.employeeid is equal to a.employeeid. Okay, so very simple. I just wrote select what are the columns I need, and then from employee I gave some alias name. When you are giving alias name, you can use this here. So you can give here like this, and I can write here this belongs to address, this belongs to address. So I wrote like this, select emp.fname because this fname belongs to employee table, emp.lastname because lname belongs to employee table, a.city and a.state because these two belongs to address table. Why do we need to write this is, sometimes you might need to print a column which is there in both the tables. For example, I want to print even employee ID. So now, if I put here employee ID, when you execute this query, this will get confused. This will get confused which employee ID you want to print. Whether you want to print employee's employee ID or address employee ID. So for that reason, you need to put employee dot. So now that you understood, like, okay, you want to print employee dot employee ID. Employee tables employee ID. And for that reason, we use alias names. So we simply wrote this select query, all the columns, and then we wrote from employee table, join. So you're joining employee table with which table? Address table. On, what is the condition? Employee ID equal to this employee ID. That's all. Write the columns you need from the table, join, which table you want to join, on. Very simple and straightforward. Let me execute this. See, now I'm saying this. Ravi belongs to Hyderabad, Telangana, and Bharat belongs to Bhopal. Sharad belongs to Kolkata. Okay? So, even in this case, I got a question saying, like, what if I put A dot employee ID? That's well and good. In this case, both are same. So, even if you put A dot employee ID, that's fine. I'll get the same result. Because you have written the condition here when both are same. Okay, so any doubts here in this query? So it's very straightforward and very simple. So select A dot employee ID, whatever columns you need, table, join, or you can put inner join, both are same. Inner join is same as writing simple join, both are same. So if somebody asks you what is the difference between inner join and writing a join, so both are same. Okay, so this is about inner join. Okay, so now we have some other types of joins. So for example, if someone sees this report, if the top management or the leadership sees this report, what do they feel? So they feel like they have companies having only 3 employees. But actually, how many employees we have now in the company? No, this is the new table. I just created sometime back. Yeah, this is, so we have 4 records, but why do you think we are not getting the 4th record, Amar? For example, if I execute this, why do you guys think that I'm not getting this 4th record here in the result, in the join? So if I execute this again, so in the first table, So here in the first table I have 4 records, in the second table I have 3 rows. But in the join I'm only seeing 3 records because why we are not getting 4th record is we don't have employee 4 in address table. So this join condition will only print those who are having. Now I have a question here. What if we send this report for the leadership? So assume that leadership has asked this report, and if we send this report for the leadership, they will think that only we have three employees in the company. So they want a report which states like if the person has not entered address, put this as blank and show me all the employees. So in that case, we need to go for outer joins. Okay, so now let's try to understand which joins we need to use. Okay, so now let's try to use outer joins. So now in this case, I want to print all the records. From which table you want to print all the records irrespective of the condition? From which table you want to print all the records now? Either from employee table or you want to print from address table? Which table? You want to print all the records from employee table. You want to print all the records from employee table. And for the non-matching records, for example, Amarnath is not there in address. So for that, put blank. So in that case, we need to put. So for if I write like this, outer join. For this outer join, which is left table, which is present on the left side of this outer join. Which table is present in the left side of the join? All of you? Yeah. All of you, I'm not seeing from response. Okay. See here, okay. Let me put this way. This is a join. So I mean, I'm asking this is right side. And this is left side. So for this join, employee table is present in the left side. Address is present in the right side. Now, what I want to print is, irrespective of whether the person has entered address or not, I want to print all the details. So in that case, I want to print all the details from employee table. So now, what I need to do is, I need to add here left outer join. When I write a left outer join, I'll print all the details from employee table. And if I don't find matching records in address table, I'll put null values. So let me execute this, you'll understand better. See now, let me put here e.employee address. Let me execute this. See now, now I'm printing all the employees. Amarnath also is printed, but city and state is coming null for Amarnath. So when I write a left outer join, irrespective of whether the condition is satisfied or not, if you don't have records in the right table, it will show as null, but it will print all the records from left table. Now if the management or leadership sees this report, they will understand that, okay, there are 4 employees in the company and Amar has not yet filled his city or state. This shows better, right? So when compared to the previous report. So inner join, what we understood from this is inner join will print only those records which are matching. Inner join will strictly print those records which are matching in both the tables. And left outer join will print all the records in left table irrespective of whether the matching record is present in the right table or not. If the matching record is not there in the right table, it will print null there. So is it clear enough? Left outer join? All of you? This is very important. Please let me know if it's not clear. Now, can you guys guess what will be the output if I put right outer join? How many rows I will see in right outer join? How many rows I will see in right outer join? Okay, let me explain this. So left outer join, we saw that irrespective of the condition got satisfied or not, all the rows from the left table has been printed. Now in right outer join, irrespective of whether condition satisfied or not, all the rows from the right table will be printed. Right table is address. So how many records we have in right table? We have 3 records in right table. So it will only print 3 records. Let me execute this. It is only printing 3 records. Now for a change, what I will do now is I'm going to add 1 record in the right table. So let me add a record in the right table. Okay, now I entered employee ID 5 in address table, but that employee ID 5 is not there in employee table. So if you see this, I have employees 4 till 4 here and 5 here, but I don't have 5 in employee table. Now I have a question to all of you. If I put here left outer join or if I put here inner join, how many records I will see? Yeah, you have to tell this properly. Think and tell me before replying. Please think twice before replying. I am writing an inner join. So if I execute this, what will be the answer for inner join? Please think twice. So inner join will perfectly check for the matching conditions. So let's try to understand. So employee ID 1, is there in both the tables? Yes. Employee 2, is there in both the tables? Yes. Employee 3, is there in both the tables? Yes. Employee 4, is there in both tables? No, we don't have. And how about employee 5? We don't have in both the tables. So it will only print 1, 2, 3. So inner join will check for perfect matching condition and it will print only for the matching records. So if I execute this, I will see only 3 records. Now question for all of you. How many records I will see in left outer join? If this is my tables, how many records I will see in left outer join? In left outer join, I will see all the records from left table. All the records from left table, irrespective of whether the condition satisfies or not. So I'll see 1, 2, 3, 4. And for Amarnath, I will see blank. I'll see null. So if I execute this left outer join, so you can see here, in left outer join, I'm seeing only 4 records. All the records in the left table employee are getting printed. And it doesn't care about employee 5, because left outer join will only care about left table. Now can you guys tell me what about right outer join? How many records I will see in right outer join? I'm executing this. So in right outer join, how many records I will see? Can you guys tell me what are the m? Some of you are telling 3, some of you are telling 4, some of you are telling 5 as well. So right outer join will print all the records in the right table. So I have 1, 2, 3, 5. So 1, 2, 3, 5 will be printed and it will not print 4. Because 4 is in this table, but 4 is not here. But 5, even though 5 is not present in employee table, but still it will print because we are writing a right arrow join, right table is address. So it will print all the records from address table, but it doesn't care about left table, what you have or what you don't have. So if I execute this, right outer table will print all the employees. See now. So this is the 5th employee record, but I'm seeing null here because I need to write here a.employee address. See now, if I execute this, I'm getting here 5 as well. But for 5, I don't have first name and last name. Because I don't have, for 5, I don't have the records in left table. Is it making sense or is it confusing? I see it is confusing because I'm seeing mixed responses from, how many of you is confusing? Okay. Yeah, it is a little bit confusing. Yeah, I'll make it clear now for you guys. Okay, so don't worry, this is the most easiest topic which we have in SQL Server. Writing joins is pretty easy. All you need to do is, I repeat again, when you are writing an inner join, okay, when you are writing an inner join, so if I do select star from these tables, inner join will only print for those records which are matching between both the tables. So I'm writing inner join for employee ID. So it will check for the employee IDs which are present in both the tables. That records only it will print when you're writing inner join. Inner join is a perfect matching condition which will check exactly the records which are matching. Now, so 1 I have in both the tables, 2 I have in both the tables, 3 I have in both the tables. So I don't have 4 in the right table, I don't have 5 in the left table. So inner join will only print 1, 2, 3. So if I execute this, it will only print 1, 2, 3. That is about inner join. When you write a left outer join, it will print all the records in the left table. And if you don't have matching employee ID in the right table, please focus here. I'm telling about left outer join. Left outer join will print all the records in the left table. And if you don't have matching employee ID in the right table, it will print null for that columns. Ideally, your left outer join, the number of rows will be equal to your number of rows in the left table. See now, if I execute this, I will see all the records. Let me put here EMP. So because my left table is employee, so let me put here employee. So if I execute this, I will see here employee 4, which is there in the left table. Since I don't have matching city and state for employee 4, it is showing null. When I put here right outer join will print all the records in the right table, all the records in the right table. If you don't have any matching employee ID in the left table, it will have null for that columns. So here, let me execute this. See now, 5, I don't have first name, last name, because I don't have for 5, I don't have in records in employee table. Now, how many of you it is clear? Okay, so now, let me modify here. Okay, let me show the tables for you. Please make a note here. Please make a note of this here. Now, can you guys tell me how many records I will have in inner join? I should not see any mistake, any wrong answer. Please think before twice before replying. So this is table employee and this is table address. So when I write an inner join, how many records I will see here? Yeah, I'm seeing the proper response from most of you. So inner join will check for the perfect matching conditions. So most of you or 99% all of you are correct. So the answer here is 3 records, because inner join will check for the IDs which are there in both the tables. So 1 is there, 2 is there, 3 is there, and 4 and 6 are there here but not here, 5 is here but not here. So the answer here is 3 records. Perfect. Thank you very much. Now, how many records?
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.